Hello everybody and welcome to this video. We're going to be telling you how to set up a Minecraft server. So step one, you have to make the folder that you're going to put the server in.
As you can see, there's just four simple steps to this. The first thing is, of course, create a folder. So you just go and you right click on your desktop and you put it in you name it. And in this case, we're naming it Minecraft Server. We've already done this, that's why we're going to delete this here in a second. You're going to see in the video, but we do already have it up there. But there you go. That's all you have to do for that part. That's step one, already complete. Very easy.
Step two, we're going to download the file from Minecraft.net.
So you go to Minecraft.net/download, which will have everything, of course, in the description explaining all this. But the latest version is the Minecraft Server 1.7.4 exec. So you download that, you're going to put it into the file that says Minecraft Server, so that you know how to find it all. We've already done this, of course, we went through everything making sure that this is as simple as it seemed to be before doing it, but that's where we are with that. The third step.
Next, we're going to find the IP address so that you can actually find your server.
And that's really easy. You just go to Google and type in, what is my IP address? We've got ours blocked out, but right under where it says Minecraft there, you would end up seeing the IP address, and this is important because
otherwise you can't get on your server.
Yes, you have to let your friends know what your IP address is. Okay, so we're now, it said setting up port forwarding. This is where you go into your router and you tell it that it's okay on a certain port to allow information exchange between like your friends and you. So the important things that you need to know are default gateway. This is like a number combination. Like for ours is 182.168-2.1, I believe. Sorry, I can't read it on our little video editing thing here. That's a common one. And there's a bunch that are common. Every router has a different one. But if you go into the, with Windows 8 anyway, if you just get into the command prompt some way, with Windows, you just get into that Windows page, you type run, you hit command prompt, and you hit type in ipconfig, it would bring up like all the information about those things, as well as your IPv4 address. Okay, so now right here you're seeing us putting in our, logging into our, router. If you're not sure what your password is, I'm sure someone at your house knows. If not, it's probably there's probably a sticker on your router. If it's not that one anymore, you can just reset your router and then go with whatever the sticker says. Okay, so now with the Dropbox here, you're going to be telling which device you want the router to be routing everything to. So as you do that, like on ours anyway, we're looking for the IPv4 address there, just to confirm that it's the one we want. We know it's this computer, so we do that. It'll put it into the next little slot there. Then we put in what ports, server ports are being used. Which in this case, if you look into the little thing that says server there under your Minecraft server, it'll point out what server ports the number is, which is 25565. So you put that in both spots here. You have to do this as both a TCP and a UDC format. I'm not sure. I'm assuming that because TCP is supposedly better, but I guess it just if you have people that are going to be using your Minecraft server, this allows them to do it no matter what their protocol is. So make sure that all your friends can join in online with you. So after that, you just basically bring up your server. You click on that and then you bring up Minecraft. It comes up, you hit play like you normally would. Then you go to multiplayer, and as you can see by ours there under where it says Ryan, that it's set up and you can have up to 20 people at a time. And it's that simple to get on this. There's other explanations out there that go into more detail about setting up for extra RAM or doing other little configs that kind of make it a bit more complicated. We'll get on with that with the next video that we do, probably next week. But with this, we just want to make something out there that was really simple to see that, boom, you get on it. The difference between this and some of the other videos is that this is all the default, so you're only going to have 1 gig of RAM, which, you know, for Minecraft, that's fine, like, especially if it's just you and a few friends, like, playing. Like, I'm sure that we could probably host, like, 20 people, but I guess it also depends on the capacity of your computer. But anyway, we'll get into more details on the other one, on how to do the configuration, what everything else means in more detail later. But, yeah, thank you for watching the video. If this is, if this helped at all, of course.
Like, favorite, subscribe, comment, share with your friends.
Yeah, yeah. Of course, share it with all of your friends so you can all have your own Minecraft servers and you're in each other's worlds and
yes,
and live your little Minecraft lives, which is awesome.
Or build a giant village.
Build a giant village, yes. Invite everyone you know.
Yes.
Okay, anyway, thank you very much.
We'll see you next time.